Okay, we're going to open the questions up to the audience. Tapi sebelum tu, just maybe just take one minute or two to wrap up. Filem Melayu Tidak Laku atau setuju tak setuju dan apa your tak laku, what can we do about it? Start with Aida.
I take a long time to think.
Laku, tak laku, what? Kalau tak laku, what can we do about it?
Oh man, there's so many things, right? banyak sangat elemen yang kita tengok. Sebab, let's go to grassroots, straight away. Berapa ramai orang nak jadi filmmaker kat Malaysia? Masa saya pergi dekat, if I went to, masa muda sikit lah, dia nak pergi dating lah konon. Pergi dekat rumah, sokong tu, nak pergi jumpa mak bapak dia. Dia cakap buat apa kerja dia? Dia cakap saya pelakon. Pelakon? Boleh cari makan? Boleh tak bayar rumah? Gaji berapa? Saya pun terduduk kan. So, dia bila, so perspektif orang pun, ibu bapa mungkin generation yang lama, filmmaking or entertainment is not an industry. So kita kena understand that it's multi-million dollars a moving daily in the entertainment industry. All of us live off this industry. We make a good living of it. We pay income tax. All of us have a good life. I'm not saying amazing life, a good life. Some achieve better and have a better life. So we can live, we can bring, you know, put our children to school and so on doing what we do. So it is an industry. If you're paying tax to the government, it is an industry. So have that awareness first. Kedua, yes, go to school, learn. Saya, I'm very unfortunate. I could not afford to go to film school. I had to learn by being an actor. I wanted to be a director from day one. Pak Idea, saya pergi berlakon, Harith direct masa tu, saya pergi assistant director dia. PM was director apa tu? Dulu
sebenarnya.
Saya belajar. So, saya pergi untuk Abada, saya nak nampak kamera. Saya buat film scope dengan Abada. Nak dengan Aziz. So, I pick. Saya berlakon dengan Yusuf Aslam. Sebenarnya, terus terang, saya tak nak berlakon dengan Yusuf Aslam. Saya tak minat filem dia. So I said, no, it's the truth. I don't lie, I tell you the truth.
No,
but the fact is, saya berlakon dengan dia sebab saya nak belajar marketing process dia. Itu je. Sebab saya buat kebilan, saya tak nak berlakon dia lagi. Tak payah. Sebab saya dah tahu macam mana cara dia nak. Sebab I want to be a successful filmmaker. I need to learn everything. So if you guys want to come and do film, do the process. Do not sit there and go, I'm just going to be writer, this is my story, go and make my movie. It's not going to happen. You need to know the entire picture, everything. Even if you're an actor, an actress, a writer, a director, a producer, you need to know everything. Then, when you are enhancing what you your art, macam, for instance, I always tell my friend Aflin, you're a jack of all trades, a master of none. Maksud apa? Kiri kanan? Kalau orang tu fokus dekat satu benda, but you know everything with information you have, and you use that one thing that you have talent and your semangat, ada, you will be amazing without even question. I guarantee you that. But sometimes kita ni malas.
Depending on the movie lah. Sebenarnya tak ada, bagi ni tak ada resepi atau ramuan yang spesifik untuk buat filem yang laku. Orang kata skrip bagus. Skrip macam mana yang bagus? You know, orang
Sampang
tak tahu nak cerita hantu ke, nak komedi ke, nak cinta ke, nak action pack ke. Itu semua nasib. Pelakon. Suka pelakon yang macam mana? Suka pelakon yang
muda. Yang muda.
Muda gitu lah.
Kan? Yang muda yang ada kontroversi. Macam kita orang dah tua tak ada kontroversi.
Saya tak ada kontroversi. Oh,
saya tak ada kontroversi. Kan, tak laku kan? So, itu pun peranan. Aku pun mungkin, we tahu sebenarnya, bila we sembang ramai, kita kat sini semua student kan? Bila we sembang student, I know you all thinkers. And I know you want to watch good stuff. That is for sure. We tahu you want to pay your ticket and watch good stuff. Good acting. Because you can judge. So, we tahu yang actually, kalau kita nak ubah industri ni, mungkin banyak caranya lah. Skrip kita kena lagi bagus, masa dia lagi panjang untuk kita Hans. Sebulan buat skrip dia sudah roll lah. So macam mana kita actor, kita nak melupas karakter pun dalam masa yang rush. Director pun ada short time untuk think and go. Producer pun sama kan, kena cepat. So mungkin itu. Nombor dua, budget. bajet kita kat Malaysia tak besar. Tapi actually bagi D, we should get credit sebab dalam dengan bajet yang kecil, kita masih mampu buat movie yang bagus. Hollywood takkan boleh buat movie yang kita ada dengan bajet yang kecil. They will never do it.
If you talk to an international filmmaker, dia tanya, how much do you make a movie for in Malaysia? I tell them, 300 to 400,000 US. You tell dia cakap apa? That is our catering budget lah.
Yes. Oh,
I'm not joking. Our the food title. Budget. Yes. Yeah. The credit title is a million over. Yeah. The back end yang tu nama-nama lain. So we are making it with what just to enhance it a little bit. You know, we are making it with that sort of budget. You know.
That worldwide.
Yeah.
Betul.
Okay, sorry.
So mungkin kita fikir juga mungkin kerajaan. Kerajaan maksud
ni?
Kerajaan
maksud ni? Kerajaan
maksud ni?
Did you mention kerajaan?
We did it. It was her.
Okay, kita actors, walaupun I bukan producer, actor, kita harus stress tau. Bila kita berlakon sepenuh jiwa dan raga and hoping people watch the movie, tiba berapa collection? 1 million. Sedih tau. Dengar macam 1 million besar. Tapi actually, kita ikutkan, director dah berpala dah ke office. 1 million bila bahagi dengan cinema, dia dapat apa? Half. 50% cinema, 50% producer. So maybe, government should impose whereby cinema jangan ambil cut besar-besar sangat lah from local producers. Ambil lah 20% ke apa ke, you know, so that producer has got more budget to roll and make better movies. Nak ambil kau besar-besar kau filem Hollywood yang dah tentu 3-4 million.
Dia memang ambil.
You know, itu satu cara maybe for me yang mungkin boleh bantu our industry. On script, I know our script memang dia sebab tadi, even daripada segi dialog. Dialog kita pun kadang-kadang agak kasar. Sebab itulah kita ada masa yang cukup untuk kita perelokkan dialog, perelokkan scene. Macam kalau kerja dengan Syed Bahu ataupun dengan Senyamak dalam kerja, I know Kak Aida pernah. Diorang memang yang lama. Dengan Aida Nerina. Diorang ada sesi di mana diorang pergi latihan lakonan untuk setiap scene. Kat situ diorang akan perbaguskan dialog. So tak semua orang dapat, tak semua movie dapat chance macam
luxury
tu.
Luxury itu.
Luxury
time.
Itu.
The time.
Luxury of time. So sebenarnya, banyak benda lah yang kita perlu ubah pun yang diakui. Cuma kita, tapi dia rasa kalau boleh orang yang menonton filem Melayu try and support us, but we trying to change. You see, kita tak tahu movie macam mana yang work, sebab kind of movie you want to watch. Bila kita buat filem yang apa sebut ni? Kita tak tahu filem macam ni you all suka. Bila kita dengar filem ni, biasa. Tapi meletup. Bila kita bagi filem yang aktornya award winning bagus-bagus, garanti semua aktor mantap, tak meletup. So macam mana? Producer akan ambil formula di mana? Ya, tak payah award winning aktor mah. I ambil pelakon, janji muda, patut mesti I boleh join movie cerita, okay? Sure, my pocket penuh.